Neuroscience as a field is becoming increasingly collaborative in that some of the most exciting work in the field these days involves knowledge and expertise from multiple fields. Our core competence is in the quantitative aspects, and we collaborate very closely with our experimental collaborators here in Pittsburgh and elsewhere to be able to make these discoveries about brain function. My group studies how the brain works. In particular, we work in computational neuroscience, which is a field that combines experimental recordings from the brain as well as the latest computational methods to study the signals that we record from the brain. In particular, we are studying how the brain learns. And so we all know from personal experience that learning to play tennis or learning a new language or as kids learning math can be difficult and take a long time. And so what we're trying to understand is what happens in the brain when we learn. One of the dreams that I have is to be able to use the discoveries that we're making about how the brain learns to help people learn more quickly. So for example, let's say you want to learn Spanish, and right now we know that it takes years to be able to become proficient in another language. But what if we can come up with a personalized curriculum in which we could take a scan of your brain to figure out ways in which you can learn more easily, and then design a personalized curriculum based on that to allow you to learn a new language or a new sport in much less time than is currently possible. One of the aspects about learning, as well as many other brain functions that we use on a daily basis, is that it requires interactions between different brain areas. And this is true for most brain functions that we use and take for granted on a daily basis. And we as a field know quite little about how the interaction between brain areas allows us to do these amazing things. And so if we can better understand how brain areas interact with each other, we can develop better treatments for helping these people. One of the challenges that we're dealing with as a field is how to record signals reliably and with high quality from the brain. So there are different ways of monitoring brain signals. For example, there are signals that you can detect from outside the brain using technologies such as fMRI and EEG. But those signals tend to be limited by the spatial and temporal resolution that we can get onto the brain's activity. There are ways in which we can go inside the brain to record much better signals, but that currently requires brain surgery and is not for everyone. And so we as a field can hopefully develop better technologies to record good signals from the brain.